Welcome to today's discussion on GST. We'll make a beginning towards one of the prominent area in GST, payment of taxes. All of us are aware that taxes which is collected by the respective registered person has to be paid to the government. So every person, before collecting tax, he'll get himself registered and he'll maintain certain documents based on which the documents and records we will be in a position to assess at the year end, or he will be in a position to assess at the month end or year end what is the tax payable, sometimes month end, sometimes quarterly end, sometimes year end, what is his tax payable. And once he arrived at his tax payable, he will adjust his tax payments. Now, as we discussed at many times, and we have crossed through a topic called as input tax credit, there would be a possibility that a person is having both input tax credit as well as his output tax liability. Come on, understand one aspect. Everybody has to incur some expenses for providing his outward supply. How much they will incur, that differs from business to business. But definitely one thing is sure. The moment you say income, it will have its associated expense. The moment you're going to come up and say we have some income, then obviously there will be associated expenses. No second thought about it. Absolutely no second thought about it. So if some of you are going to say, we are engaging in some trading activity, good. You earned an income of, let's say, some 35 lakhs in trading activity. You traded what? Some goods. You would have procured that goods and traded. Somebody says, sir, we have engaged in some service activity. And in that service activity, we got voluntarily registered. Good. And we did a turnover of some 8.5 lakh rupees. For providing that 8.5 lakh rupees services income. And because he is voluntarily registered, he has to pay GST. No doubt about it. Any person after registration, there is no threshold exemption at all. Once you are registered, you have to pay GST. On that 8.5, he'll pay GST. But to do this 8.5, he would have procured some telephone services, courier services, some accounting services, renting of office services, renting of computer, repair maintenance of computer, so on and so forth. On all the inward supplies, there would be a GST paid by this person. So this morning, or I'll rephrase it, this session, we will take it up a clear discussion of, no doubt, existing ITC can be used for your set off of ITC of your existing ITC on inward supply can be used for set off of your output tax payable. But very interesting to note now how it can be set off, what you can use it for, what purposes. So to discuss about those aspects alone, we will take it up a crucial topic called as in payment of taxes. One subtopic called as utilization of input tax credit. Just this one slide. Today's main agenda for our discussion would be only taking up this slide. In my humble view, minimum, it would take up somewhere around 1.5 hours for our discussion. A very important slide. There are 2-3 amendments. You will definitely be tested questions in this topic. If at all a question is planned in this topic, it will be planned here only. Okay, because you had so much of amendment this time. Rule 88, Rule 88, Rule Section 49B, Section 49A, Proviso 2, Section 49, all are amended. Okay, CD, Proviso 2, 49. So a consolidated of all these amendments, and I also remind you, the approach to adjustment itself is changed after this. After your 1st April 2019, let me repeat, after 1st April 2019, the set of approach, the utilization approach is changed. Now, what is that changed? What it is? What is the adjustment that has been foreseen? All that we will discuss in today's presentation. Before that, all of you are all aware, and you all also did problems. If a person is going to have output tax payable, okay, output tax payable, what he will do first is he will adjust his input tax first and arrive his balance tax payable. So from the output tax, let me repeat, from the output tax, he will adjust his input tax and arrive a balance tax payable. And that balance tax payable, he will pay through a cash account. That is, the taxes can be only be paid in two ways. Cash means don't think a cash payment. No. You are settling that payment through a bank payment mode or a cash payment mode. You can settle that payment through a cash or bank payment, but for the government, they get this money. So the settlement can happen through a bank or a cash payment, but government will call always this as money paid by credit, money paid by cash, and money paid, or what is the money payable? What is your liability? Liability payable. I'll be as slow as possible. A very important topic. Damn sure you'll get questions. That's all I can highlight to you. So come back here. Output tax. What is the liability will be recorded somewhere in the register. How much input tax credit? How much input tax credit they have? That will be recorded somewhere. And what is the cash that they used? That will also be recorded somewhere. Now, a point that I want to drive home is, let's say somebody has to pay a 5,000 rupees tax. Someone has to pay a tax of rupees 5,000. What he will do? When a person is liable to pay a tax of rupees 5,000, first he will go and search how much credit he has. Now, let's take up, he has a credit of 3,000 rupees. Then what he will do is, he will first adjust his 3,000 rupees credit. Credit will be nothing but what? Input tax on inward supply. Whatever purchases he has made, whatever expenses he has made, on all that he has paid some tax. That tax is nothing but his input tax credit. Now, this balance 2,000 rupees will be paid by him. How he will pay? It should be paid, you are saying, no? It should be paid as cash, government will say. It's a government word. The difference should be settled through cash, government will say. Now, it will be paid by how? By either debiting his bank account or payment by cash. The mode is bank or cash, but the term that is used is called as your cash payment. Now, come back here. Lot of us, the problem for us is when the moment we hear a word called as cash payment, is need to be settled by cash. No. You settle through a bank channel also, you are paying through. You are paying only, no. You think in this way. There are two types of popular accounting. Mercantile accounting and cash-based accounting. Yes or no? Now, mercantile and cash-based accounting. Government always follows cash-based accounting. That is to say, if it receives only, it will treat it as what? Income. In fact, from there only this word inspired, called as cash. It is not referring to a bank payment. It refers to a accounting treatment. Okay, accounting treatment. That money to be paid in cash to the credit of government. Hope you could be able to understand. That money should be paid to the bank, paid to the government, to the credit of government. To the credit of government, it has to be paid in cash. So I'll rephrase it. That 2000 rupees should be received by government. When government will say that they have received, only it is received by them. How they can receive it? Through two modes. Either as a cash payment in a bank or as a check payment. I mean banking payment, bank related payments. Two ways it can receive. Now, if you are running a professional, if you are doing a professional accounts, an architect, an engineer, who all will follow cash basis. Now, what is the difference between a cash and a mercantile basis? In a mercantile basis, you will accrue expenses. You will accrue income. You will accrue your expenses payable. Whereas, in a cash basis, when it comes to in a cash basis, you will not accrue expenses and all. Let me repeat, you will not accrue expenses and all. Everything will be as it is. You will proceed with it. Now, why I want you to think all this is very simple. In case of these circumstances, in case of cash payments, in case of all these models, understand there are three ledgers now will come to you. There is something called as electronic liability register. Electronic liability register. 1 minute. Electronic liability register. Now, as far as electronic liability register is concerned, this register records for what is your tax liability. More about this register in our subsequent discussions we will take. Now for the time being, understand broadly. This register, electronic liability register, records your tax liability. Followed by electronic credit ledger records your ITC input tax credit on inward supply. What is your ITC taken on inward supply? That is recorded in electronic credit ledger. Electronic cash ledger. How much money you have to pay to government, okay? And how do you pay that? GST payable by cash. What is your GST payable by cash? That is recorded in three ledgers. We have a very detailed discussion on these three ledgers. Maybe we'll spend 1.5 hours only on these three ledgers. Understand the movement of this ledgers, what will be debited, what will be credited. All these are all important. In short, we will call this as electronic liability register followed by electronic credit ledger and electronic cash ledger. In your electronic cash ledger, so why I want to highlight is, if there is a tax, let me repeat, if there is a tax, that tax can be set off only in two ways. If there is a tax, the tax can be set off only in two ways. One, you can use your existing input tax credit on inward supply and set off the tax. Two, you can make a payment for it. You can make a payment for it, very popularly called as cash payment. You can pay the tax and settle the liability. There are only two ways in which a tax liability can be settled. Where, sir? Any tax law. Now, preferably any taxation, transaction-based tax law, settling principles will go like this only. For example, just be with me. We'll take up a... One, yeah. Assume for a moment, there is a GST output. GST tax liability on outward supply. Oh, very carefully, I am highlighting it. Output GST payable on outward supply of goods or services. As it been highlighted, it is a output GST payable on outward supply of goods or outward supply of services. Here, what is possible is, this is broadly can be, if you say this is your liability, this liability can be settled generally by two ways. What are the two ways in which it can be settled is what we are looking at, it which you all know. This liability can be settled either by one, this liability can be settled either by option one, always option one, using your input tax credit on inward supply. By using your input tax credit on inward supply, you can always settle this liability. Option two only will be what? Using your cash payments. Let me repeat. Option one will be using your existing tax credit facility. To put it in a very simple way, input tax credit on inward supply of goods or services. Similarly, I will also have an input tax credit of inward supply on goods, or as well as I will also have it on what? Services. Input tax credit on inward supply of goods input tax credit on inward supply of services. I will use that and I will set off my liability. Or sometimes that will be used, or it will be, you'll use what? The same, the tax liability will be paid. Tax liability will be paid in cash through bank. Through bank payment. Through bank payment. Okay. Now, again, here you have a small challenge. Excuse me. No. Again, here. Which has to be used first? Should I need to pay this, pay that? I think I have made my symbols very clear. First, always you will use your credit only. After that only you will use your what? Cash payment. If there are no credits, then only you will use your cash. But the very interesting part of this discussion is not this. Correct. Idukagave indha diagram kodla namba. The very interesting part of this discussion is now output tax liability has there is a possibility of three or four output tax liabilities. So what is that you are saying, sir? Yes, there is a possibility of three or four output tax liabilities. Offset possibilities. First one, you will have a liability of CGST. You will have a liability of output tax. Output tax liability of SGST. You will again have a liability of ITST. Let me repeat it. So this is how it will be selected. CGST, SGST, ITST. Output, output. So if you be very clear, either lane or output CGST, SGST, ITST. Now what is this, sir? See, all of you reading for your CS course will know that there is something called as GST compensation. So there will be a liability on GST compensation. So why I want to highlight all this is a lot of us thought all GST is same. No, this money will go to central government. this money will go to state government, this money will go to common pool and then get distributed among central government, state government and whomever for working calculations, all that. Now again, coming back to our discussions, when it comes to input tax credit also, you will have the same split off happening here. When it comes to input tax credit also, you will come across, just give me a minute. In case of input tax credit also, you will come across things like this is happening because there is a possibility of CGST input tax credit, SGST input tax credit, and IGST input tax credit. So simultaneously, a GST compensation input tax credit. So in case of these situations where there is a possibility of CGST input tax credit. To make the differences only, I'm giving in a different color. Let me repeat it. I don't want you to think, sir, aduvum SGST, iduvum SGST. Illa. Adu output SGST, idu input SGST. Rendum vera. You all know the purpose behind it. Okay? Don't underestimate a diagram. Don't underestimate a color. Consciously, I am doing it. Don't think it otherwise. Idu illama naanga vera color edukala. Just want to draw the distinction. அது அடிஷன் அமௌண்ட், இது டிடக்ஷன் அமௌண்ட். ஸோ அதுவும் ஜிஎஸ்டி காம்பன்சேஷன்ஸ், இதுவும் ஜிஎஸ்டி காம்பன்சேஷன்ஸ், என்ன சார் வித்தியாசம்? அது ஜிஎஸ்டி காம்பன்சேஷன்ஸ் ஆன் யோர் அவுட்வர்ட் சப்ளை, திஸ் இஸ் அ ஜிஎஸ்டி காம்பன்சேஷன்ஸ் ஆன் யோர் இன்வர்ட் சப்ளை. போத் ஆர் டிஃபரெண்ட். ஆன் யோர் அவுட்வர்ட் அட்ஜஸ்ட் யுவர் இன்வர்ட், யூ வில் அரைவ் யோர் டாக்ஸ் பேயர். வென் திஸ் இஸ் தி பிராடர் ஸ்கெட்ச் சார், தட்ஸ் ஆல் பிளேஸ். That's beyond that, I don't have anything. Now, if this is your broader sketch, that output GST payable on outward supply of goods or services, input tax credit on your inward supply, when this is adjusted, then only what happens is you will arrive your cash payment. In cash payment also, it is not easy. In cash payment also, you will pay separately. You will pay separately as CGST, SGST and IGST. It is not common. CGST, SGST, IGST, everything is paid separately, or GST compensation. So nothing is, you are not paying, you are nowhere paying GST and all. The differential amount paid by cash. The differential amount paid through cash ledger. What will be paid through cash ledger? Your differential tax payable. The differential tax payable is being paid through your cash ledger. So come back here. Intention of our discussion, just to feed in you a thought that there is something called as your tax liability. That tax liability can be settled. Tax liability can be settled through an input tax credit and a cash payment. Like how you have a different tax liability, you'll also have input tax credit in different head. How that adjustment is going to happen? If you want to draw a clear parallel to this topic, for income tax, in case you are more interested, then your parallel to the income tax topic discussion will be set off carry forward losses. If you have a current year business loss, you will adjust with what first? Is it a current year profit or a current last year profit? If you have a business profit of current year and there are no business loss of current year, and there is only business profit in current year, but you have a carry forward business loss and depreciation loss, which you will adjust first. So think on that line. Verbatim, inspiration, these topics are all common topics. Idea is verbatim same. Intention is you have a credit of CGST. We all know input tax credit alone can be used first. Input tax credit alone can be used first. When we all know input tax credit alone can be used first to set off your tax liability, then only your cash payment will be used. If this be the situation, your CGST credit, you'll first set off with what tax? Your IGST credit, you'll set off with what tax? Now, in case you have a more IGST, what would be the situation? In case you have more CGST and SGST, what would be the situation? A discussion about all that will be utilization for input tax credit. Sir, what I have learned over the last 35-40 minutes, you have learned how a tax liability will be set off. What do you mean by electronic cash ledger, electronic credit ledger, electronic liability ledger? You have also understood there will be an individual settlement of all these transactions. So that is your takeaway over the last 45 minutes. If you could able to understand this diagram, if you could able to understand this diagram well, then yes, I think you have understood a very substantial topic that we are going to move forward in terms of discussion. As I earlier mentioned, I'll be as slow as possible because I know this topic is tested for exam. Having known this topic will be tested for exam, I want all of you to appreciate in its fullest effort. Coming back here, getting into the discussions relating to it. Now, as you all now aware, you all know how this, all this, what is the input tax credit, everything happens. Now, as you all know, input tax credit of IGST. See, there is a three-step process. I'll go one after the other. I will not dump all the information at one go. Let me repeat. Consciously, I will give you small sticks to break. You break all the small stick. After that, finally, we will put all that five sticks together and try to break it. If you start with five sticks, it will be difficult. Too much to remember will be there. To start with, as per ITC provisions and as a registered person, procuring various inward supply of goods or services, they will have a accumulated IGST credit. Let me repeat. They will have a accumulated IGST credit. This accumulated IGST credit will be first used for set off output IGST. So you have a input tax credit of IGST accumulated on inward supply that can be first used for set off to utilize with your output IGST payable on outward supply. Hope you will understand. Input tax credit will come on inward supply. Output tax credit will be there on your outward supply. On all your income, you will have an output GST payable. On all your expenses, you will have an input GST payable. So you can take a credit of input GST payable, set off with your output GST. For that purposes, ITC of IGST. First will be adjusted with output tax payable of IGST. You have adjusted. You have a still carry forwarded money. You have still more money. Then the law says you can adjust the excess money with output tax of CGST. And then you can adjust the excess money with output tax of SGST. So let me repeat it. ITC of IGST will be first adjusted with output tax of IGST, then with output tax of CGST, and then with output tax of SGST. I still have balancer, very good, carry forward to next month. How long I can carry forward? You can carry forward for n number of years. There are no time limit. Time limit is only for taking input tax credit. You recollect your time limit before filing of next year September return. Before filing of next year, before the due date of filing next year September return or filing of annual return of this two, whichever is earlier. You read the time limit in section 13. That is for the purpose of taking your credit. Having taken the input tax credit, it can be carried forward for n number of years. There is no possibility of your time limit and all. You can carry it for n number of years. Now, I'm back. ITC of CGST. You have a credit of CGST. That credit of CGST will get first setted off with output tax credit of CGST and then setted off with output tax liability of IGST. Input tax credit of CGST will first get setted off with output tax of CGST and then set off with output tax of IGST, followed by input tax credit of SGST or UTGST as the case may be. Input tax credit of SGST or UTGST. Input tax credit of SGST or UTGST. In that case, it will be used for your output tax or UTGST first, and then it will be used for payment of your output tax of IGST. The adjustment model will be like this. Broadly understand. This is the first phase of understanding. You have second phase, third phase, and the fourth phase. After all four phases of understanding, you will have a complete understanding of this discussion. There is a credit of IGST. That credit of IGST will be first setted off with output tax of IGST. I have used it full. I still have a credit. Then you can use it for setting off output tax of CGST. I have completely set it off CGST. I still have credit. Then use it for output tax of SGST. Followed by, I still have ITC of ITST. Very good. Carry forward that number. A person has a ITC of CGST and a ITC of SGST. First, he can set off with respective taxes. If you carefully note, output tax of ITC of CGST will get first adjusted with output tax of CGST. ITC of SGST will first get adjusted with output tax of SGST. Once this set off is over, then only they are allowed to set off ITC of CGST. If you have an excess credit, more than adjustments, you can set off, you can use it for output tax of IGST. ITC of SGST, if you have a more credit, then you can use it for output tax of IGST. Let me repeat it. Here there are about 5-6 scenarios we can foresee. having broadly discussed the first scenario, this is how the set of principles will go. What we will instantly do is, we'll take up a problem and try to discuss it. Don't think problem is a big, big problem. All are small, small case study questions, which can come even as an MCQ. Case one. Output tax payable for the month. CGST, this is a CGST column. Particulars. This is a SGST column. And this is a IGST column. Output tax payable lakh and 75,000 of CGST. Again, lakh and 75,000 of SGST and 2,50,000 of your IGST. Input tax credit was 1,25,000 CGST, 1,25,000 SGST, 1,50,000 your IGST. All you need to decide or calculate it, what is the GST payable for the month? Hope all of you could be able to see the respective sheet. I believe you all able to see the sheet. Yes. Now, what is the GST payable for the month? Arrive those numbers. Put it on the chat box so that we can move forward. A particular presentation format I will discuss with you once you are done with this. So you have to also report it separately. Don't report it total GST payable and all. There is no total GST payable. Apple, mango, orange. We don't want the fruits. We only want how much apple, how much orange, how much mango. Always it will be like that only. Good. This is the first question. Take control here itself. Next 5 more case studies are there. So obviously that control will come over a period of time. Sudarshan, Sanjay, easiest question under the earth. A question that will not come in exam. Varada sir. Satyama varada. In the kelvila varave varada. Sir, meeri vandudna. Sorry, that is the easiest paper under earth. Kindly clear that paper. Shashikala answer is true. Achudan answer is true. Pranav answer is true. Anand Vishwanathan answer is true. Malavika answer is true. Good. Quick. I give you time. I want lot of you to answer. I'm very clear. I will not push you. Maybe one question, two question I'll request. After that, I'll leave it as it is. For me, nothing. As I already mentioned. Neha through. Gangadharan through. So Madhumita through. Lavanya wrong. Yes, Samit. We'll use the ITC of IGST to pay ITC of CGST. You'll use your ITC of IGST to pay output tax liability of IGST. Rajendra Tilak through. See, in that total GST payable or concept take a total customs duty mari. It is an independent pocket. If you come up with the answer 2 lakh, I will simply say wrong only. Rajendra Tilak. Point question here is CGST evlavu, SGST evlavu, IGST evlavu. Individual ada report pananom. That is why I told apple, mango, orange. Euro, dollar, yen. My GST payable of CGST so much, SGST so much, IGST so much. Total GST payable, abdinga or concept e kadaiyadu. Sir, ivlo naal work panname, adha first learning inga. Adukada ivlo periya diagram, adukada and the splitting off. There is no concept called as total GST payable, it's a humbug concept. Okay. In life, you will not have a real transaction like this. So, points for our discussion is don't get carried away by those discussions. That discussions are all not valid discussions. Done? True? Yes. So, if you come up with an individual answer, then it will be termed as a right answer. So, idu vandu customs duty mari kadaiyadu. Customs duty la add pannome sir. Customs duty act solluchu appadi pannunganne. Inga GST act appadi sollala. Okay. So, if we add it, so it will not form partnership. Now, any case, come back here. Faisal, answer is, check your answer. Faisal, answer is wrong. Somewhere something went wrong. I don't know. What went wrong, I don't know. Edo tappa use panirkinga. I'll come up with that answer solution and all. Revised answer, Lavanya through. ITC of CGST will first be used to pay output tax of CGST. Yeah. Yes, fine. Yes, Amit. I don't know why you have joined later. SGST, Faisal. What about your CGST, SGST? Illa, edho tappa irukku, Faisal. We'll come back. Shweta Sundar, through. Savita, through. So your discussions will become very simple. To start with your tax payable, let me repeat, tax payable input tax credit, tax payable input tax credit. CGST, SGST, and IGST. Let me repeat. This may be in your working notes as this will form part of your working. maybe I will refrain myself only to this format, a very seasoned format, a very settled format. Okay. So no second thoughts about this format. To start with your IGST. Now, integrated goods and services tax, or at least you can call it as integrated tax. You have a integrated tax of 2,50,000 payable. Let me repeat. You have an integrated tax of 2,50,000 payable. So let me repeat. Again, you also have an input tax credit of 1,50,000. I don't know why you all picked up IGST credit and set it off. Some of you set it off CGST liability. Now, first, you should set off the input tax credit only among that head. You have a IGST liability and there is a IGST credit. How much? 1,50,000. Now, that 1,50,000 credit should be first adjusted with your tax payable of IGST. That's all. So, there will not be a need for setting off CGST. There will not be a need for setting off SGST as there is no credit at all. There is no credit at all. You will not be in a position to set off anything. So there will be nothing for you to set off and respective heads only is taken care of as of now. Now you will have a 1,00,000 payable, gross tax payable, sorry, net tax payable. The same will be paid in cash by your electronic cash ledger. Similarly, in case of central tax, again, your tax liability was 1,75,000. Again, you had a ITC of input tax credit of SGST of 1,25,000. Very simple. Modala adu adhe care take pannikom avladhaan. You will first care take every tax credit will care take of its liability only first. There are no excess. If you have excess only, you can use it for what? IGST. And at no stretch of imagination, you can think a CGST can be set off with what? SGST. Not applicable. Sir, where it is told, sir? Come back to your presentation. 1 minute, come back. Read through this presentation. Yola raga padichukon papo. IGST of your input tax credit of IGST. Input tax credit of IGST. First will be set off with output tax of IGST. Input tax credit of CGST. First will be set off with output tax of CGST. Input tax credit of SGST. First will be set off with output tax of SGST. If you have excess, then you can adjust the IGST with CGST and SGST, the CGST with IGST, and SGST with IGST. Done. That is how it can be settled. No. So hope you get reminded of this. I'll go back to the problem. Again, followed by state tax. Same, 1,75,000. but this time you can use your state tax payable. You can use your state tax payable. You can use your state tax payable. First, you have a SGST credit. You can use it for what? Your output tax of SGST. Adike patala, apra nane ennathu keduthun polam. IGST keduthun polam. Never, you can use it for the purpose of what? That's all. And very interesting to note, if you sum up these two numbers, you will get your total credit of CGST, input tax credit total. If you sum up these two numbers, you will get a credit of SGST total. If you sum up these three numbers, you will get a credit of your IGST token. Okay. Carefully go above and check. This totals will match. Okay. If you have a credit of IGST, you will first set off with this, then with your CGST, then with your SGST. Similarly, if you have a credit of state, then you will adjust. நம்ம எல்லாருமே தப்பு பண்றது ஒருதான். இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் ஐ கேன் புட் சம் கலர் டிஸ்டிங்ஷன். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் யூ வில் யூஸ் ரெஸ்பெக்டிவ் டாக்ஸ். லெட் மீ ரிபீட், ரெஸ்பெக்டிவ் டாக்ஸ் டு பி அட்ஜஸ்டட் வித் ரெஸ்பெக்டிவ் ஹெச். ஆஃப்டர் தட் ஒன்லி யூ வில் யூஸ் இட் ஃபார் டு பி அட்ஜஸ்டட் வித் வாட் அதர் ஹெச். ஆஃப்டர் ஒன்லி யூ வில் யூஸ் இட் கேன் பி அட்ஜஸ்டட் வித் அதர் ஹெச். First, you will use it only for what? Your head adjustment. Major head, that head adjustment. Okay. This color patterns shares you something. The color pattern shares you a very important information that CGST cannot be used for SGST and SGST cannot be used for CGST cannot be used for SGST and SGST cannot be used for CGST. ரொம்ப கிளியரான பேட்டர்ன். A lot of you got it. So you would have not done in this format. I am not sure whether you did in this format or any other format. This is a recommended format. Let me repeat. 220. This is a recommended format. Okay. I'm not saying you have to do like this only. But in case if it is a descriptive problem, it has to be done like this. And in a model like this, if you are trained like this, you will never make a mistake. Even let it be an MCQ. One ramsha extra. True. Can able to appreciate this discussion. So what is the final takeaway? That taxes will be adjusted with that head. If there is excess, then only you will take decision which has to be setted off. Okay. In that set off, there is some process. Based on that process only it will happen. At no point in time, you can use SGST for paying CGST. At no point in time, you can use the credit of CGST for paying SGST. It has to be adjusted. And then if there is an excess, it has to be carried forward. Can we move forward? Yes. So if all of you got this right, we can move forward to a next learning or the first important learning based on amendments. The first learning is ITC of CGST and SGST can be used. ITC of CGST and SGST can be used for payment of output tax of IGST, CGST or SGST or UTGST, as the case may be. Only after ITC on account of IGST is fully utilized towards payment. When I can use my CGST and SGST. If we have no number free are going to use for non-nanachola, that's the first restriction is now. Okay. If you apply the restriction order, then the principle apply. The first restriction says always, always IGST has to be used first. IGST carried forward credit should be brought to zero. Then only you can use what? CGST and SGST without bringing down IGST to zero, without using it fully, nil, nil. You cannot use your CGST credit and SGST credit. Before me getting into some discussions on this, take it on a lighter note. Don't take it up very seriously, this discussion. Come back here. Intentions are very clear. In case of set-off process, first ensure output tax of IGST, ITC of IGST is first adjusted with output tax of IGST, then with your output tax of CGST and SGST, and ensure ITC is completely utilized and brought to nil. ITC should be brought to nil of ITC of what? IGST. Then only you can use what? ITC of CGST and ITC of SGST. Inge nil varama idha tottinga nambal tensnaido. Yaar sir avaru? A new section, section 49A. Section 49A comes out and insists that ITC of IGST has to be used first before using CGST and SGST. Having learnt this small understanding, we will now go make our discussions on this topic. Come back here. I'll re-amend the same problem in a different context where the numbers will be little different. That's all. This is a case study too. In a case study 2, you have a output tax payable of 250,000 CGST, 250,000 SGST, and 5 lakhs of IGST. Again, you have a lakh and 50,000 of CGST and SGST credit, and 7,50,000 of not 7,50,000, 7 lakhs of IGST credit. So, question before you is, what is the GST payable of CGST, SGST, IGST? So, go ahead, calculate, text your answers in the screen. Case study number Case study number 2, output tax of CGST 2 lakhs, output tax of SGST 2 lakhs, output tax of IGST 5 lakhs, input tax credit of CGST 1,50,000, input tax credit of SGST 1,50,000, input tax credit of IGST 7 lakhs. All you need to understand, is your, how much is your CGST, SGST and IGST payable. See, if you have any carry forward number, kindly share that carry forward number also. Okay. Actually, three answers are possible for this question. Not one answer possible. One correct answer. Moon correct answer. Okay. All right, two correct answer. Sanjay, Aishwarya, Shashikala, quick, somebody virtually sitting somewhere, they could able to do, means you could also able to do. Come on, quick, push yourself. Namakkenna nootonna namakkenna da. Pranav, nice writing, Pranav. You took time to write the convincing answer. Good. Pranav through, Faisal through. Sudarshan, your answer is also through. Amit. So what is the answer, Hamid? Finally, you have described something. Subhash answer is true. Neha answer is true. Deep, the answer is true. Akshudan, then you have not adjusted. Sorry. You have to go and adjust it. You should ensure IGST is brought to nil before touching CGST credit. And the individual oda paisa mottam gali aayirukanum. Avar da individual da IGST. Orthar CGST, orthar SGST. Appadi vechukonga. CGST generally will not change. So, Ammava putrunga. SGST state to state might change. So, put it in other words. Yeah. Oh, you wrote below. Sorry. Outward liability of SGST 1 lakh. Done. Shobha, check your answer. Malavika through. Madhumita through Anand Vishwanathan. Illapa, Anand Vishwanathan edho thappa irukku. You cannot have a carry forward like that. Gangadharan through Rajendra Tilak. No Rajendra Tilak. You cannot have like that. See, when you set off IGST with SGST carry forward, then is it not your IGST carried forward should become nil? Amavalliya. ஒரு நிமிஷம் யோசிச்சு பாருங்க. அம்மாவா இல்லையா? குட். அகேன் பீப்புள் ஹூ யூஸ்வலி யூஸ் டு ஆன்சர், யூ ஆல் ஆன்சர். ஐ லீவ் இட், ஐ வில் நாட் புஷ் எனிபடி. No, Lavanya, your answer cannot be like this. CGST, SGST, IGST, nil, and carry forward amount is 2 lakhs. Possibility kedaiyadu. Possibility kedaiyadu. Engayo problem thappa irukku. No. Shweta Sundar, check. And the 1 lakh, 1 lakh, enna nu paarenga. Paarenga. Now, I'll take you through. Be with me on the worksheet for a minute. Then you can copy it. You can do whatever you want. I'm not sure consciously I never put a total here. இங்க total போட்ட எனக்கு தெரிஞ்சு இங்க போட தெரியாதா? போடக்கூடாது. ஏன்னா இது வேற, இது வேற, இது வேற. You have an integrated tax liability of output tax payable of 5 lakhs. Similarly, you have a central tax liability of 2,50,000 and you also have a state tax liability of 2,50,000. This is your total tax. You have a IGST credit of 7 lakhs. Credit is more than your output tax liability. So what you will do is first adjust your IGST credit with 5 lakhs. When you adjust that, ITC of your ITC of IGST has to be first adjusted with output tax of IGST. After that, it has to be adjusted with output tax of CGST, and then only it has to be adjusted with output tax of SGST. So coming back here, ஓ அப்படியா சார், அப்படி அட்ஜஸ்ட் பண்ணமா? நான் எதுவும் சொல்ல, சில பேர் மாத்தி அட்ஜஸ்ட் பண்ணாலும் ஓகேன்னு சொல்லியிருக்கேன். So you'll get a reason later. First, you will adjust with IGST liability. We have adjusted. You still have a carry forward credit. Sir, how I will know I have a carry forward credit? Carried forward ITC to next month. ITC, carry forward ITC to next month. Now, எதுக்கு இந்த மாசமே, இந்த மாசமே ஏதோ காசு இல்லைன்னு பேசிட்டு இருக்கோம். நாங்க அடுத்த மாசத்துக்கு இதை சேவ் பண்றோம்ன்ற மாதிரி ஏதோ பேசுறோம் நம்ம இப்போ. Now, point that I want to drive home is your total eligible credit is 7 lakhs. Against this, you have used 5 lakhs. You have a carry forward credit. Why a carry forward credit is required? One minute. Now, Why? You have a liability, you know, you have a central tax, you have state tax. Before using central tax, before using state tax, this has to be brought to zero. This is the first condition. Condition number one, your IGST has to be brought to be zero before touching your CGST credit and SGST credit. If you want to touch your CGST, SGST credit, ensure you bring your IGST to zero. IGST will be first utilized. Input tax credit of IGST will be first utilized for input tax, sorry, output tax of IGST. Then it will be used for output tax of CGST. Some of you can mention here as 2 lakhs. You will get zero. Then what you will do? You will have a central tax. You have a central tax of payable 50,000 rupees. You have a central tax liability. Given the popping IGST nilla nil. Yes. I will use your central tax 50,000. So I don't have a central tax liability. Central tax cannot be adjusted with state tax. You have only state tax liability. So you will use your state tax liability. SGST, ITC with SGST. All of you don't be in a hurry. Na solirken, moon answer irken solirken. Purumiya wait pannunga. Chat box la question potu potu onnu agadhu. Na moon option yu mudikkera. Adhukapparam puriyilena kelunga. Now, if you come back here, there will be a SGST payable of 1 lakh. And there will be a CGST carried forward of 1 lakh. Let me repeat. Sir, is this is a correct answer? Now, yes, this is a correct answer. Okay. Because you have simply followed the rules of, you have simply followed the rules of your section. Section simply says, you all could able to view the PPT. Can somebody text me? PPT. Yes. Okay, okay. I'll take it. Now, point here for our discussion is ITC of IGST will be used first for output tax of IGST, and then it will be used for output tax of CGST, and then it will be used for output tax of SGST. That is one way of understanding. And there is another way of understanding for this, which will come out and say, output tax of 5 lakhs will get first adjusted. Will get first adjusted with your 5 lakhs, and you will have a liability. You will have a liability of 2.5 lakhs of SGST payable, CGST payable. Now, option one. Let me repeat. I am not calling this as final answer. Option one. Adjust the excess credit of 2 lakhs of IGST with your CGST payable. Can be adjusted, sir? Yes, it can be adjusted. Adjust here so that you can adjust your ITC of CGST, 50,000 for CGST liability. So look here, CGST liability became nil. CGST carry forward 1 lakh. Ippo puriyum yen indha format la namba podrom nu. Okay, அதுவும் அடுத்த கேஸ் ஸ்டடியில இன்னும் நல்லா புரிஞ்சிடும் இந்த ஃபார்மேட் ஏன் நம்ம ஃபாலோ பண்ணி ஆகணும். லெட் மீ ரிப்பீட் இட், இன்டெலிஜென்ட் பீப்புள் வில் ஃபாலோ த ஃபார்மேட். அவ்வளவுதான் நான் சொல்ல முடியும். பியாண்ட் தட் ஐ வில் நாட் ஷேர். அ பக்கா ஃபுல் ஃபிளஜ்டு ஃபார்மேட், எவ்ரி திங் வில் பி டேக்கன் கேர் ஹியர். நவ் சிமிலர்லி த There is a IGST credit, sorry, CGST credit. IGST credit brought to zero. That is why we are using CGST and SGST. Now, there is a CGST credit. You cannot use it for anything. You can use it only for CGST output liability, zero. You can use it for IGST liability, zero. You cannot do anything. Carry forward. You have a output tax of SGST. You have a input tax of SGST. You can utilize that. Yes. Once you utilize, SGST credit becomes completely useless. There is a tax payable. Now, in this option of option one, utilizing the excess ITC, utilizing the excess ITC for output CGST in full, and then for output SGST. Sir, is this is allowed? Yes, this is allowed. Nobody will question this. Is it wrong and all? Some of you, in fact, had answers like this also. Some of you had answers which will come out and say this. But very interesting to note, none of you had an answer which I'm going to discuss now. None of you came up with answer. At least I don't remember anybody who got an answer like this, which was option two. Option two, utilizing excess ITC for output SGST in full and then for output CGST. Can it be done like this, sir? Why not? It can be done like this. So, bringing back the question to the back position. Sorry. ITC situation. One minute. E32. Now, as usual, you will take your IGST credit, set off with IGST land. You have a carry forward ITC. Sometime a person thinks differently. Why should I use it for CGST? Why not I use my excess money completely for what? SGST. Use it. You brought your IGST to nil. Now you can go use your CGST credit for set off your CGST liability. You have a CGST liability of 2,50,000. As against, you'll use your 1,50,000. You will have a liability payable of 1,00,000. Very interesting to note. Nothing. It cannot be used. That's all. Output payable is there. Entire ITC brought to nil of CGST. That's all. SGST credit is there. Now this SGST credit, you can use it. You can use it for set off of SGST. You have a carry forward credit, then there are no tax payable at all. Sir, CGST is there. SGST credit cannot be used for CGST. None of you did it in this format. It will not strike anybody. Now I'll ask one more question. If you're going to be a CFO of any of these companies, okay, will you use option one or option two? Or you'll come up altogether with a different option. Okay. In my view, you'll come together with a different option, which is a very ideal option, which is equally utilizing the excess credit. Okay. Equal utilization of excess credit, utilizing the excess ITC of IGST. I think that word was missing. Excess ITC of IGST. Utilizing the excess ITC of IGST. Utilizing the excess ITC of IGST. Utilizing the excess ITC of IGST for output CGST and SGST equally. See, there is no point in creating in one place 1 lakh asset and creating in another place 1 lakh liability. Here, you created a liability at state tax and created asset at central tax. In other case, you created a liability on central tax and an asset at what? State tax. Yes or no? But what is the ideal way? Ideal method. Let me repeat. An ideal method is this option 3. I'm happy. See, narepel toni panningla, tonama panningla an kuda theriyala. A lot of you did it rightly here. So come back here. Back to square one discussions. You have a IGST liability of 5 lakhs. You have a credit of 7 lakhs. Where you have first adjusted IGST for it. Balance 2 lakhs is there. You made a point very clear. I will use 1 lakh for CGST, 1 lakh for SGST. How you got that number, sir? Balance credit divided by 2. Equally, I'll put it. If I distribute it equally, what happens? Very simple. You have a liability of 1,50,000. You have a credit of 1,50,000. Adjusted. Adjusted. Then again, you have a liability of 1,50,000. You have a SGST credit of 1,50,000. Adjusted. When you adjust, your net tax payable is nil. A lot of you got nil. Now, in my view, the very right method is this third option. Third option is a very, very correct approach where you use this, which is also supported by your Rule 88A. Rule 88A of CGST rules. Rule 88A of CGST rules allow you to do it in this format. Rule 88A of CGST rules allows you that yes, you can set off the credit equally also. So, hope you could able to had a clarity. இந்த மூணு ஆன்சர்ல எந்த ஆன்சர் வந்தாலும் கரெக்ட். பட் ஐடியல் மெத்தட் இஸ் வாட்? ஐடியல் மெத்தட் இஸ் யூ ஷுட் கெட் அ நில் டாக்ஸ் பேயபிள் பிகாஸ் யூ ஹவ் யூஸ்ட் இட் ஐஜிஎஸ்டி கிரெடிட். சி, தட் இண்டிவிஜுவல் மணி இஸ் அ காமன் மணி. இட் ஹாஸ் டு பி யூஸ்ட் ஃபார் போத் காமன்லி. ஸோ யூ டிஸ்ட்ரிபியூட்டட் இட் காமன்லி. ஐஜிஎஸ்டி இஸ் அ காமன் கிரெடிட், ஹாஸ் டு பி யூஸ்ட் ஃபார் போத் காமன்லி. சார், இஃப் ஐ யூஸ் இட் ஃபுல்லி ஃபார் சிஜிஎஸ்டி, நான் ஏற்கனவே சொல்லிட்டேன், தெர் இஸ் நோ ஹார்ம். If you put fully in 2 lakhs, no harm. You will have what? A tax payable in SGST and a tax credit in CGST. If you use it fully for state, what will happen? Nothing. A tax payable in CGST and a tax credit in SGST. Are you a best CFO? Are you a best financial advisor? If you are a best financial advisor, then what you will do? At any point in time, your tax payable will be less. What is the tax payable? Nil. Why? What you did? What magic happened here? Equally you used. The moment you equally used, it gets distributed equally. Sir, this is allowed? Yes, this is allowed. No. We will read that point and come back here. Order of utilizing ITC will be ITC of IGST to be used first, and balance, if any, can be used for payment of output tax of CGST and SGST. So your order of utilization, in fact, a lot of you used in this format only. Similarly, ITC of CGST or SGST can be used for payment of ITST only after ITC of IGST becomes nil. So you will use the order only in this way. Order of utilization of ITC will be ITC of IGST to be used first, and balance can be used for payment of output tax of CGST and SGST, and ITC of CGST, that is separate, ITC of CGST, SGST can be used for payment of IGST only after ITC of IGST becomes nil. Without ITC of IGST become nil, you cannot use your CGST and SGST balance. Can you able to appreciate this discussion? And they are silent here. As far as this overriding is concerned, yes, you can do it. Ideal option will be this. Learn one more clause, last clause, which comes from same rule 88 itself. ITC of SGST can be used for output tax of IGST only if ITC of CGST is fully used. Nalla paarenga reverse order la pesirpa. ITC of IGST pathi pesiruka maata. ITC of SGST. ITC of SGST can be used for output tax of IGST only if ITC of CGST is fully used and becomes nil. If your ITC of CGST is fully used and it becomes nil, then only you can use what? ITC of SGST. In our discussion of metaphor, mother's money should be used first, and then only the daughter-in-law's money should be used for the individual. That is how provisions are worded. That is just for your understanding and information. Nothing great beyond that discussion. Don't give life and all to that discussion. It will be waste. Having discussed the case study 2, a lot of you got it right. I'll take you through case study number 3. I want a lot more people to get it right. Let me repeat. A lot more people to get it right. Case study number 3. Yes. So I hope all of you could be able to see the Excel sheet. Yes, no? So your question number three is something like this, a case study number three. Case study number three. Output tax payable is 250,000 of CGST, 250,000 of SGST, and 2 lakhs of IGST. Followed by input tax credit of CGST 325,000. SGST 325,000, IGST 50,000. Previous GST return closing balance of ITC on CGST and SGST is rupees 50,000 each. Adhu vera doubt varum ungalku. 50,000 each. Okay. So which means 50,000 CGST, 50,000 SGST. Sir, divided by 2 podakudada podakudadu each nu artha varudhu. Okay, so come back here, go ahead, set off, arrive a number and say me what is your CGST, SGST, IGST payable, what is your carried forward ITC. A standard problem, exam problem. Or rendu mark ku MCQ a kekkanonnal idu da renda kelviya ketruva. What is your GST payable? What is your carry forward credit? No hurry, do it aram se, get a right answer. See, these are all topic, when you get a right answer, it's extremely good. Gangadharan, check your answer, carry forward ITC alone. Sanjay, I think it is true. Sashikala, I'm not sure. Sashikala, I'll confirm. Sanjay, also check your answer. I have a doubt. Neha, your answer is true. Faisal, you should check your answer. Aishwarya, answer is true. Sashikala, answer is true. Okay, Sanjay, check your answer. Malavika, check your answer. No, it is not possible. Sudarshan, ipo neenga set off paningala, ipdi panna koodadhu. This is what that proviso means. This is what that rule 88 is, one more condition. You should ensure CGST is brought to nil before you use what? SGST. Okay? Can able to appreciate this discussion? You go back to the PPT once again. Anga or condition kadasiya padipom paarenga. The last condition which we are reading it here. ITC of SGST can be used for output tax of IGST. Only if ITC of CGST is fully used. So in the ITC or adjustment, in order of utilization, ITC, yaar periyalna, no doubt IGST. When IGST is there, it can be used. Now, CGST to SGST, CGST to IGST, SGST to IGST, or order la dhaan ponom. CGST has to be brought to nil before you use ITC of SGST. So, Sudarshan, you have to rework on the answer. Anand Vishwanathan through. Deepthi, I don't understand. Because wholesome credit is adjusted, IGST, CGST, and the rest is adjusted for SGST. No, I don't understand. On the other hand, your revised answer is true. Achyudan, this is what I was highlighting now all along. Niga forward la panambod, IGST equal to distribute panla. Ana, CGST, SGST credit equal to distribute panna kudadu. Yes, sir. Condition. Rule 88 la potrupa. ITC of SGST can be used for output tax of IGST only after IGST. Idhe pona problem oda influence. Adu appadi dhaan irukum. See, pona problem ungalukku kudutha influence, pona problem kudutha learning. Sir, idhu optimum utilization ah illaya? Idha paarenga. Panna kudadunu rule la sollita, appuram panna kudadhu dhaan. So there is no question of optimum utilization and all here. Come back here. We will do this problem. I'll do this. A lot of you got it right. Okay. Utilizing of input tax credit for the tax period this month, this and that month. As per rule 88 of CGST rules. There will be a output tax liability of CGST of 250,000. No. 2 lakhs. IGST is 2 lakhs. அப்புறம் சிஜிஎஸ்டி வில் பி 250,000 and SGST will be 250,000. And your order of utilization of ITC, there and all, there's some changes is there, we will do it everything. In case of carry forward ITC, you should do a small working here. ITC eligible for the month. This is additional working. Maybe you can also bring it as a bottom working. ITC eligible for the month. For utilization. ITC eligible for the month or tax period for utilization, which will be your that month credit plus opening balance. Let me repeat, if your number work pannano, that month credit plus opening balance, that month credit and opening balance for IGST is not given, so zero. That month credit, opening balance, ITC eligible for the tax period, for utilization. What is this number? This is the credit that you can use. If you want, you can have this as an opening number also. I don't mind in it. This is the opening number. So you have a credit of 375,000 that can be adjusted. Similarly, you have a credit of CGST, SGST 375,000, IGST of 50,000. Okay. Now, how are we going to adjust? As part of this discussion, first you will use your integrated tax, always integrated tax. You will use your integrated tax credit, ITC of IGST. Yes, ITC of IGST, you have 50,000 rupees. You will use 50,000 rupees for what? Output tax liability. Two things have happened. You still have a tax payable of 150,000 and ITC brought to nil. இது நில் ஆனதுக்கு அப்புறம் தான் வாட் வி வில் டூ இஸ் வி வில் கோ ஃபார் சிஜிஎஸ்டி எஸ்ஜிஎஸ்டி அட்ஜஸ்ட்மெண்ட். யூ வில் யூஸ் யுவர் சிஜிஎஸ்டி கிரெடிட், இன்புட் டாக்ஸ் கிரெடிட், ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டு செட் ஆஃப் யுவர் சிஜிஎஸ்டி லயபிலிட்டி. எஸ் அட்ஜஸ்டட். யூ ஹாவ் கேரி ஃபார்வர்ட் நம்பர். இங்கே பாருங்க, டாக்ஸ் பேயபிள் நில் ஆயிடுச்சு. யூ ஹாவ் அ கேரி ஃபார்வர்ட் நம்பர் ஆஃப் 125,000. சிமிலர்லி யூ வில் யூஸ் யுவர் எஸ்ஜிஎஸ்டி கிரெடிட், எஸ்ஜிஎஸ்டி கிரெடிட் to set off with your SGST liability. You will use your SGST credit to set off with your SGST liability. Then that will also be brought to nil. You will have a carry forward number. Now some of you will think, I have a 150,000 rupees liability. Why can't I equally adjust 75,000 and carry forward it? அதுக்குதான் ரூல் 88 ரெஃபர் பண்ணுங்கன்னு சொல்றோம். கம் பேக் ஹியர். ஆர்டர் ஆஃப் யூட்டிலைசேஷன் ஆஃப் ITC will be, what is my order? ITC of IGST will be used first and balance, if any, can be used for ITC of CGST and SGST. Similarly, ITC of CGST, SGST can be used for payment of IGST only after IGST becomes nil. IGST became nil. Further proviso says, ITC of SGST can be used for output tax of IGST only if ITC of CGST is fully used and becomes nil. Now, in this problem, what will happen is, you will use first your ITC of CGST. You have used completely, CGST brought to nil. and then only you will use what ITC of SGST, where you will have a carry forward balance of SGST 1 lakhs and tax payable nil. Now, a particular order la pone. First I will ensure the IGST. IGST becomes nil. 1 minute. First, let me repeat. First, I ensured IGST became nil. The moment IGST became nil, then only what I did, I went and told I will utilize my CGST and SGST for respective head utilization. So CGST and SGST input tax credit was first used for what? Respective head set off. They're being set off and then used your SGST credit, then used your SGST balance to set off your CGST, IGST liability. Then only used your SGST balance to set off your IGST liability. It has to be adjusted only in this order. But option is there. Yella vaatiyum first IGST nilla idicha abdin paakano. அது நில்லாத வரைக்கும் அதை செட் ஆஃப் பண்ணணும் சார். இந்த ப்ராப்ளம்லாம் டக்குன்னு நில்லாயிடும். ஏன்னா இங்கே வந்து நீங்கள் சிஜிஎஸ்டி எஸ்ஜிஎஸ்டி எப்படி செட் ஆஃப் பண்ணுறீங்கன்னு கண்டுபிடிக்கலாம். அண்ட் ஒன்ஸ் கிரெடிட் ஆஃப் சிஜிஎஸ்டி வில் ஃபஸ்ட் பி யூஸ்ட் ஃபார் சிஜிஎஸ்டி, கிரெடிட் ஆஃப் எஸ்ஜிஎஸ்டி ஃபஸ்ட் பி யூஸ் ஃபார் எஸ்ஜிஎஸ்டி. ஒன்ஸ் தட் இஸ் ஓவர், தென் எக்ஸஸ் பேலன்ஸ் இஸ் தேர் தட் வில் பி ஃபஸ்ட் யூஸ்ட் ஃபார். யூ ஷுட் யூஸ் யுவர் சிஜிஎஸ்டி இன் ஃபுல், தென் ஒன்லி யூ கேன் யூஸ் யுவர் எஸ்ஜிஎஸ்டி. It sums up your discussion relating to utilization of credit. Let me repeat again. A lot of you got it right. Some of you was on a notion, sir, na ye inge one. Some of you was carried away by previous problem, sir. I have a liability, no. Equally, I will use this. நான் ஏன் இப்படி போடக்கூடாது? ஸோ தட் ஐ வில் கெட் 50,000 அட்ஜஸ்டபிள். லெட் மீ ரிப்பீட் இட். வென் இட் கம்ஸ் டு ஐஜிஎஸ்டி, ஐஜிஎஸ்டி செட் ஆஃப் வித், வென் இட் கம்ஸ் டு இன்புட் டேக்ஸ் கிரெடிட் ஆஃப் ஐஜிஎஸ்டி, யூ கேன் யூஸ் இட் இன் எனி ஆர்டர். பட் வென் இட் கம்ஸ் டு சிஜிஎஸ்டி யூஸ் ஃபார் ஐஜிஎஸ்டி, எஸ்ஜிஎஸ்டி யூஸ் ஃபார் ஐஜிஎஸ்டி, யூ ஷுட் என்ஷூர் சிஜிஎஸ்டி இஸ் ஃபுல்லி யூஸ்ட். And then only who's, what is used? IGST is used. Done? இப்படிதான் பண்ணமா சார்? ஆமா, இப்படிதான் பண்ணணும். You should get IGST. Let me repeat. IGST will become zero. SGST will be 1,000. Sorry, or 1 lakh rupees of balance. Done? All of you got it? Any doubts here before we move forward? Just make yourself comfortable. As I earlier mentioned, our whole agenda today was just to concentrate on this slide. You'll solidly from a CA final, CA inter perspective, solidly you'll get one full-fledged exam problem here, preferably case study 2 or case study 3. Your exam problem is case study 2 or case study 3. Idha exam problem. Case study 1 satyama kanavula kuda varadhu, edhirpaarkave paakadhinga. Case study 2 la last ah punch veppan. Eppadi punch veppana, what would be the best option of utilization if you are a CFO of a particular company? இது மாதிரி வார்த்தைகள்லாம் கேள்விப்பட்டீங்கன்னா இட் ஷுட் ஸ்ட்ரைக் டு யூ ஆப்டிமம் யூட்டிலைசேஷன் ஆஃப் ஐடிசி யூ ஷுட் கம் அப் வித் வாட் டு வி மீன் பை ஆப்டிமம் யூட்டிலைசேஷன் ஆஃப் ஐடிசி சார் விச் மீன்ஸ் யூ ஆர் யூசிங் த ஐடிசி ஃபார் அ ஸ்பெசிஃபைடு பர்பசஸ் யூ ஆர் யூசிங் தட் ஐடிசி ஃபார் அ வெரி வெரி ஸ்பெசிஃபைடு பர்பசஸ் அண்ட் விச் கம்ஸ் அப் வித் சர்டன் லாஜிக்ஸ் அசோசியேட்டட் வித் இட் ஸோ தட் இஸ் யுவர் டிஸ்கஷன் ரிலேட்டிங் டு இட் ஒன் மந்த் One minute. Oh. Now, can some of you check, have you received an Excel sheet? I have just shared this Excel sheet. Utilization of input tax credit, a 30 KB file, a very small file. Okay. Just open and see. If you see in mobile phone, if you see in tab, you will not get it. If you see through, if the whole session, you are viewing it through a desktop or a laptop, then only you will be able to get the file. Let me repeat, that old discussions will remain safe. So if some of you are viewing it from a desktop laptop, don't say me, sir, I have not received it. From a mobile phone, don't say me, you have not received it. This is, that will happen. A few of you commented that you have received it. Yes. So, that sums up your discussion for the day, morning session. The whole idea was to learn the discussions relating to utilization of input tax credit in its complete perspective. I think that was fairly successful. In the evening session, initially we will do one problem just for a better, more understanding, and then proceed with some more topic on payment under GST. What is electronic cash ledger? What is electronic credit ledger? What is electronic payment ledger? How the respective ledgers are used for setting off this liability. Now you saw it as a problem. How that problem will be actually appearing in the system and how the cross references do happen and what are these ledger meant for, how it will set off and all will happen. So that followed by interest calculation. Next important area there is interest calculation. So those two discussion are the most important discussion apart from payment of taxes, in payment of taxes, apart from TDS and TCS. My intention is TDS and TCS. We will postpone it to tomorrow's morning class. We will take it up, all those ledgers, interest calculation as evening session discussion, and then proceed forward accordingly. Thank you all for effective and patient listening. Thank you. Any doubts? Yes, I am here. You can always ask.